top 10 famous human on Earth. Number 10, Albert Einstein. The reason for Einstein's fame is surely that his earliest, and best known, achievement, the 1905 special theory of relativity, seemed to have come out of the blue, without any prior achievement. Like Newton, but unlike Charles Darwin, he did not have anyone of distinction in his family. He was not notably excellent at school and college, unlike Marie Curie. In fact, he failed to obtain a university position after graduation. He was not part of the scientific establishment, and worked mostly alone. In 1905, he was struggling as a mere patent clerk, with a newborn child. Regardless of whether we grasp relativity, his apparently sudden burst of genius inevitably intrigues everyone. Number 9. Christopher Columbus. Italian navigator, colonizer and explorer whose voyages led to general European awareness of the American continents. He was who completed four voyages across the Atlantic Ocean that opened the New World for conquest and permanent European colonization of the Americas. Unfortunately, it's not true. Finally, we have found he was a great con man. Columbus was likely not the first European to cross the Atlantic Ocean. That distinction is generally given to the Norse Viking Leif Erikson, who is believed to have landed in present-day Newfoundland around 1000 AD, almost 5 centuries before Columbus set sail. Some historians even claim that Ireland, St. Brendan or other Celtic people crossed the Atlantic before Erikson. While the United States commemorates Columbus, even though he never set foot on the North American mainland, with parades and a federal holiday, Leif Erikson Day on October 9th receives little fanfare. Number 8. Johannes Gutenberg. Johannes Jeans Fleischt zur Leiden zum Gutenberg, century 1400 to February 3, 1468, was a German goldsmith, inventor, printer, and publisher who introduced printing to Europe with the printing press. His introduction of mechanical movable type printing to Europe started the printing revolution and is regarded as a milestone of the second millennium, ushering in the modern period of human history. It played a key role in the development of the Renaissance, Reformation, the Age of Enlightenment, and the Scientific Revolution, and laid the material basis for the modern knowledge-based economy and the spread of learning to the masses. Number 7. Kai Lun. Kai Lun, century 50 to 121 CE, political official in Imperial China, formerly romanized as Cai Lun, courtesy name Jingxiong, was a Chinese inventor and eunuch court official of the Han dynasty. He is traditionally regarded as the inventor of paper and the papermaking process, in forms recognizable in modern times as paper. Although early forms of paper had existed in China since the 2nd century BC, he was responsible for significant improvements and standardization of papermaking by adding essential new materials into its composition. Number 6. Paul of Tarsus, one of the most notable of early Christian missionaries. Credited with proselytizing and spreading Christianity outside of Palestine, mainly to the Romans, and author of numerous letters of the New Testament of the Bible. Paul the Apostle, commonly known as Saint Paul and also known by his Hebrew name Saul of Tarsus, was an apostle, although not one of the 12 apostles, who taught the gospel of Christ to the first century world. Paul is generally considered one of the most important figures of the apostolic age, and from the mid-30s to the mid-50s AD he founded several Christian communities in Asia Minor and Europe. Number 5. Confucius. Chinese thinker and social philosopher, founder of Confucianism, whose teachings and philosophy have deeply influenced Chinese, Korean, Japanese, Vietnamese and Indonesian thought and life. Confucius was a Chinese philosopher and politician of the Spring and Autumn period. The philosophy of Confucius, also known as Confucianism, emphasized personal and governmental morality, correctness of social relationships, justice, kindness, and sincerity. His followers competed successfully with many other schools during the Hundred Schools of Thought era, only to be suppressed in favor of the legalists during the Qin dynasty. Following the victory of Han over Chu after the collapse of Qin, Confucius's thoughts received official sanction in the new government and were further developed into a system known in the West as Neo-Confucianism, and later New Confucianism, modern Neo-Confucianism. Number 4. Buddha. Spiritual teacher and philosopher from ancient India. Founder of Buddhism and is also considered a Gautama Buddha in Hinduism. The Buddha, also known as Siddhartha Gautama or Siddhartha Gautama, was a philosopher, mendicant, meditator, spiritual teacher, and religious leader who lived in ancient India. Century 5th to 4th century BC. He is revered as the founder of the world religion of Buddhism. He taught for around 45 years and built a large following, both monastic and lay. His teaching is based on his insight into dukkha, typically translated as suffering, and the end of dukkha, the state called nibbana or nirvana. The Buddha was born into an aristocratic family, in the Shakya clan, but eventually renounced lay life. According to Buddhist tradition, after several years of mendicancy, meditation, and asceticism, he awakened to understand the mechanism which keeps people trapped in the cycle of rebirth. The Buddha then traveled throughout the Ganges plain teaching and building a religious community. The Buddha taught a middle way between sensual indulgence and the severe asceticism found in the Indian Sramana movement. Number 3. Jesus. Jesus, circa 4 BC to circa 33 AD, also referred to as Jesus of Nazareth or Jesus Christ, was a first century Jewish preacher and religious leader. He is the central figure of Christianity. Most Christians believe he is the incarnation of God the Son and the awaited Messiah, the Christ, prophesied in the Old Testament. Virtually all modern scholars of antiquity agree that Jesus existed historically, although the quest for the historical Jesus has yielded major uncertainty on the historical reliability of the Gospels and on how closely the Jesus portrayed in the Bible reflects the historical Jesus, as the only records of Jesus's life are contained in the four Gospels. Jesus was a Galilean Jew, who was baptized by John the Baptist and began his own ministry. He preached orally and was often referred to as Rabbi. Jesus debated with fellow Jews on how to best follow God, engaged in healings, taught in parables and gathered followers. He was arrested and tried by the Jewish authorities, turned over to the Roman government, and crucified on the order of Pontius Pilate, the Roman prefect. After his death, his followers believed he rose from the dead, and the community they formed eventually became the early church. Number 2. Isaac Newton. Sir Isaac Newton Press, the 25th of December 1642, the 20th of March 1726-27, was an English mathematician, physicist, astronomer, theologian, and author, described in his own day as a natural philosopher, who is widely recognized as one of the most influential scientists of all time and as a key figure in the scientific revolution. His book Philosophiae Naturalis Principia Mathematica, Mathematical Principles of Natural Philosophy, first published in 1687, laid the foundations of classical mechanics. Newton also made seminal contributions to optics, and shares credit with Gottfried Wilhelm Leibniz for developing the infinitesimal calculus.
Allahu Akbar. أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله أشهد أن لا أشهد أن محمدا رسول الله أشهد أن محمدا رسول
The central human figure of Islam, regarded by Muslims as a prophet of God and the last messenger. Also active as a social reformer, diplomat, merchant, philosopher, orator, legislator, military leader, humanitarian, philanthropist. The first person on Heart's list is the prophet of Islam Muhammad. A selection that generated some controversy. Heart asserted that Muhammad was supremely successful in both the religious and secular realms. He also believed that Muhammad's role in the development of Islam was far more influential than Jesus' collaboration in the development of Christianity. He attributes the development of Christianity to Saint Paul, who played a pivotal role in its dissemination. Following the attestation to the oneness of God, the belief in Muhammad's prophethood is the main aspect of the Islamic faith. Every Muslim proclaims in Shahada, I testify that there is no God but God, and I testify that Muhammad is a messenger of God. The Shahada is the basic creed or tenet of Islam. Islamic belief is that ideally the Shahada is the first words a newborn will hear, children are taught it immediately and it will be recited upon death. Muslims repeat the Shahada in the call to prayer, Adhan, and the prayer itself. Non-Muslims wishing to convert to Islam are required to recite the creed which is true Muhammad is a messenger, Allah is one God. In Islamic belief, Muhammad is regarded as the last prophet sent by God. He is light to the whole universe.